served in the first class dining saloon.
My dear Mr. Latimer, prepare to greet our clientele. Our meeting is imminent. Our having just rung the dinner bell, it won't be a novelty. Previously have seen them all before. As usual, you should be aware of what's in store. We serve them on the Baltic, on the Oceanic, Olympic art, majestic art. Today's the same, there's nothing's changed. Mr. Austin takes his toast dry. Mr. Strauss likes the grouse with the sauce on the side. And the Wideners love kidney pie. Bring it hot, if it's not, they'll be fit to be tied. They're accustomed to the best of all that money buys. The mother-free enterprise has given this privilege to the rich. When they're idle, they're entitled to the luxury which we provide. That's where the souls are pride. Which is why we're always there with our special form of care for every hungry millionaire. By now they're all arrived. The dinner seating for Friday, April the 12th, is now being served in the first class dining saloon.
Eating!
Keep the captain's table pristine. Here we seat the elite whom we happily serve. Here they dine on fine French cuisine. It's the creme de la creme, exclusive preserve. It's the pleasure of the leisure class's greatest wits to be where the captain sits when taking the dinner on the sea. Giving deference to their preferences, the Sanji font, we play a part in a perfectly working machine. You should ever be aware this is a privilege great and rare, a special burden that we bear in our respective lives. The dinner seating for Saturday, April the 13th, is now being served in the first class dining saloon. Third class passengers are reminded not to bring food below to their cabins.
What's the meaning of that then?
It encourages the rats.
What? They got rats aboard a brand new ship.
They're always the first aboard.
Well, they're welcome to have a part of my share.
Bane, I know that name.
Yeah, you've probably run into my wife. She likes dancing with millionaires.
Yes, quite so, sir. My condolences.
It seems like she just wants more out of life than what I can give her.
Isn't that always the way, sir? I had a wife once.
Oh, well, what happened?
Nothing, I still have her. In all my years, I've never seen it so cold.
Is it my imagination, or are we moving faster than ever before?
Mr. Strauss, but I don't suppose there's anything much.
Mr. Etches, is something wrong?
I don't think so, ma'am. I'm just following orders. Wake up! Wake up!
Gentlemen, could I have your attention, please? The captain would appreciate it if you were all wearing
servers. Mr. Etches, I'll be right with you, sir.
Mr. Etches, please, what the devil is going on?
Be straight with me, man. Are we in any danger?
Oh, danger, Mr. Strauss, on this ship.
Mr. Alster, please, your life belt. Mr. Guggenheim, please put it on now. Captain's orders, ladies and gentlemen, wear your life belts. Mrs. Widener, if you would, ma'am. Mr. Thayer, we must insist now. It's a mere formality, there is no cause for concern. We'll be on our way.
She's damaged one of her weak propellers. We could be delayed for an entire day, sir.
I don't like the way this sounds.
Not a bit, not a bit, not a little bit.
We spent 1800 pounds.
Not a bit, not a bit, not a little bit. This is not the sort of voyage we pay for. I demand to know what the ship is sailing for right now.
Uncommonly lucky. In my 43 years at sea, I've served on them all. All of the White Star ships. And in all that time, I've never been in, nor even seen a shipwreck, nor any other calamity worth speaking of.